To that end, a new statewide alliance has been created to take on some of the inevitable challenges ahead. I'm live now with Tyson Eckerle, Deputy Director of Zero Emission Vehicle Infrastructure for GoBiz. That's the Governor's Office of Business and Economic Development. Tyson, good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Definitely. This new group is a not-for-profit public-private partnership, right? And we're calling it ARCHES, which now stands for the Alliance for Renewable Clean Hydrogen Energy Systems. It's a mouthful. What does that all really mean?
So really what ARCHES is designed to do is to go after federal funding that was through the IIJA Act, the bipartisan infrastructure law. And it's up to $1.25 billion we can bring into the state of California to launch a renewable hydrogen energy economy.
All righty. And as you were just talking about, late last month, it's President Biden through that bipartisan infrastructure law that has made $8 billion to create 6 to 10 hydrogen hubs, H2 hubs, they're calling them, across the country. The maximum grant you referenced, $1.25 billion. And of course, California is angling for the max. How does ARCHES and the creation of that alliance fit into tapping into that money?
So ARCHES is a really important partnership for a number of reasons. We're bringing in multiple partners. So we're deeply partnered with organized labor, with the University of California, with Renewables 100, but also hundreds of industry partners. And the importance here is bringing the voice of everybody together so that we can speak with one unified voice from California to the federal Department of Energy in terms of building out this market in a way that will really work for everyone, with a big focus on reaching disadvantaged communities and the communities that have been impacted the most by climate change, poor air quality, and lack of access to jobs. I think we can fix all of that with this renewable hydrogen economy.
This whole effort is one of the largest investments in history by the Department of Energy, and many people may not realize that hydrogen can be produced from wind, from solar, nuclear energy, or by using methane while capturing resulting carbons to reduce emissions. So there are lots of ways to get the state on track with this and get our initial concept proposal into the feds, right?
That's right. That's right. So there's a ton of opportunity, and that's the exciting part about hydrogen. We can leverage all sorts of renewable resources to make this happen, from wind and solar, using electrolysis, but also biomass to strip hydrogen off as well. And so our job here is to really make hydrogen affordable so that all the sectors of the economy can leverage it to get to, carbon neutrality and even carbon negative outputs.
The president wants 40% of overall benefits to certain federal investments like these H2 hubs to flow to disadvantaged communities, communities you just mentioned. We've talked in the past about the state programs that do exist to help all people get in on EV driving in general, when it seems as if these cars are only for the wealthy. How will ARCHES help with this goal of reaching and truly serving these communities?
Well, it's focused on it. So we want to beat the Justice 40. We're trying to direct all these benefits to the communities that need it the most. One good example is in the port complexes in California. A lot of our drayage trucks move through those communities. We have an opportunity to make those zero emissions so that the air that people who live there breathe is cleaner. But it's not just about cleaning up the air. It's about creating access to economic opportunity. A lot of infrastructure will need to be built to make this all work. And that really means jobs, and not just jobs, it's careers and family supporting careers. And that's why organized labor has been so supportive and a great partner through all of this.
With the state's goal of going to all new electric vehicles and dumping not only gas but diesel, there's a lot of concern about what happens with our trucking industry and the movement of goods. We know Tesla is online to deliver Pepsi its first electric semi this December, a $180,000 semi. It's supposed to have a 500-mile range between charges for ventures like that and for the average driver. Where are we when it comes to places to charge? How many plug-ins have we added for folks since the beginning of the year?
Okay, so when we talk about plug-in charging for people, we've added over 1,000 direct current fast chargers for California drivers, which, if you look back, so 2021, we added just over 800. So we've already added over 1,000 this year, and the year's not out. So it continues to get easier and easier. I think one of my favorite stats comes from EVgo, which is one of our partners on building out this network. But in their network, 80% of Californians live within 10 miles of a fast charger.
And that's something that's going to give people comfort. And it's really knowing you're going to be able to power your car, I guess, that's the biggest thing that could persuade people or convince them to purchase one of these cars, even through some of the state programs. Because if you're nervous about being able to eventually use it, you're probably not going to buy it. So as often as we can get those numbers out about all the new places that are coming online to charge, that's going to maybe make people feel comfortable getting in early before their deadlines to all of this.
That's right. We're trying to create as much opportunity as possible through public charging, but also in the hydrogen economy. There's a lot to do to get to carbon neutrality, but we have all the resources in California to make this happen, you know, especially from a renewable perspective. And we really look forward to helping the country move aggressively towards a carbon neutral society that really benefits all.
All righty. And we will be checking in on it every step of the way. Thank you so much.
Thank you for the opportunity.